which is, what is death? We are going to inquire together, what is death? And also we are going to talk over together, what is it that continues? And the continuity is a movement of time. So we must ask also, is there anything permanent in us, in the world, outside of us? Is there anything imperishable that cannot be destroyed, that is endlessly permanent? Man has asked this question from the most ancient of times, because he sees around him everything in a flux, everything changing, gaining, losing, being destroyed and put together again. And we also see in ourselves changing, not only biologically, but psychologically. We're all moving a little bit, bit by bit, moving, changing. Not fundamentally changing, but little. So seeing all that, this constant change, dying and being reborn, one asks, is there anything permanent, lasting? And what is that thing that lasts? Is it a continuity of what we are? You understand? Does this all interest you? Yes. Don't just say yes. That's no fun. But if you are really interested in this, because it has to do with one's life, one's daily life. And is there anything in one's daily life that's permanent? There's always at the end of that so-called continuity, there is death. One has lived 90 years, or 50 years, or 10 years, and during those 80, 90 years, there's been a long continuity of memory, continuity of activity, labor, striving, aspiring, hoping to make oneself more excellent in some skill or other, or inwardly, psychologically, to find something that is not always changing. So we see all this, an ancient oak dies. Everything seems to come to an end, die. And observing all this, one asks oneself, as you are, I hope you are asking yourself, is there permanent something that will last, that will have its roots in some place that will always grow, will always be immense, permanent. Right? Don't you ask all these questions? Or I'm asking for you. And so we are asking what is continuity. What is it that continues in our daily life? Is it not memory? A series of associations and a continuity exists also between when one thought is silent for the moment, another thought arises. There is an interval between those two thoughts. And in that interval, we observe a sense of timeless existence for a second. But that interval between two thoughts is still thought in absence. Thought then is absent between those two intervals, but is still two thoughts.